There is crashing on the first turn. Riders coming off of the berms. One of them is in a Takati. Marty Hart has flipped end over end. There are four or five riders down in the first turn. You look there, they rolled him over in a field of green. I would have said it earlier, the only way that American Honda could not capture a title here today was if they didn't compete, if they broke or got pushed down. And Marty Hart rolls over on the first lap. We just traded hats. Up front, he won the Boyd Texas race. Support Kawasaki rider number 7 from Garner, North Carolina. He loves this rough racetrack. Steve Mendenhall. Denny Fennell. Sean Finley. Dangerous Denny Fennell, the Woodland Royal from the Pacific Northwest, is number 2. Mendenhall, Denny Fennell, Sean Finley. The first Honda in is Roger Bowman from Fort Dodge, Iowa, the privateer. And everything changes. Where's Jimmy White? Where's Marty Hart? Donnie Luce in the back of the pack. Two more positions up is Marty Hart. He is 120 yards back of the leaders. He has flat got some catching up to do. The leader is Steve Mendenhall. The Southern boy with the accent from Garner, North Carolina. Let the South lead the Northwest on a Takati by Kawasaki. A86, KXT 250, they are flying.
Well, hard to believe that Marty would roll over in the first lap.
20 minutes, he could catch him. You've seen it done at the Supercross at 20 and 40 minute motos. You've seen it in the Trans Ams. Riders come from dead last to score a victory. But these KXTs are double quick. My, are they fast. The liquid fuel. Kawasaki integrated power valve. Kipps Performance Takati. Named for a Mexican city. They are as hot as the temperatures are in Mexico. Takati. Steve Mendenhall. Dangerous Denny Fennell. Number 6. A young rider. A lightweight rider. And a little guy at that. From El Cajon, California. Sean Finley is 3rd. Is Ronnie Madel. Dallas Yamaha and Kawasaki. A Yamaha is number 5 in the world championship race here at the Coyote Park. And way back in the pack, world champion, former world champion, Takati's Jimmy White, riding for all he's worth. He is 7, 8, 9 positions off the leaders, Sully. And behind him is John Neary. Further back is Marty Hart. Hart's picked up 2, 3, 4 positions on the last lap. If the rear fenders can stay bolted to these 86 KXT Kawasaki's, they can pull off a 1, 2, 3, and 4 victory. The closest one to him. Number 159 is Roger Berman from Fort Dodge, Iowa. What an incredible turn of events. The main event isn't over until you clock 22 minutes. What a race. Yamaha moving up. You know the list, cyclocross fans. Here comes number 466, Ronnie Madel from Dallas, Yamaha, and Kawasaki. Ronnie Madel from Dallas, Texas. Yamaha is number 4 and moving. Marty Hart is number 11 and moving up. He has picked up 10 positions. There are 21 riders that started this main. All 21 are still on the racetrack.
The crowd running from all points of the raceway. This is the final. The racetrack preparations could not have been more perfect.
Number 7, Steve Mendenhall from Gardner, North Carolina. Team Green, Bobby Johnson, Custom Distributing is his sponsors. JP Racing, Bassani, Park Unlimited. He won the Indianapolis, top privateer rider in Indy. Tipton, Iowa, he won the National. He won rounds number 3 and 4 of the Grand National Tour. And 2 weeks ago, he won Mike Kidd's Houston, Texas finale. Mendenhall. Denny Fennell, the Honda rider, is moving up. It is Roger Berman. What a guy. Berman running behind the Northwest favorite. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've ever been to Washougal, Washington. Well, you look back in the past. Kawasaki rider, number 31, Jimmy White. Hot on his tail is Marty Hart, Honda fans. Hart is moving up. He is number 9. Look at him. He takes 2 Ducatis in the air. Way to the outside. Hart gets both of them. You look at him. Marty Hart is flying. My Lord, you don't think you're getting your $6 worth here. We'll give it back to you twice. Mendenhall is out front, and he is cruising. Number 7. U.S. Kawasaki support rider. Now look at the Honda Best is a privateer rider. Roger Berman. Oh, is his wife Chris excited on the sidelines from Fort Dodge, Iowa? The motor built by Mike Ellsbury of Performance Parts in Ogden, Iowa, has pulled ahead of all but one green motorcycle. ATV as you will. Mendenhall, you better crank your KX2. Roger Berman is number 2. Kawasaki leads the Honda, leads the field, the KX2. Fennell having problems. You look here. Oh, my Lord, on the sidelines. There's former motocross pros from Portland and Washougal. They are concerned. Fennell is having problems. Denny Fennell has backed off. Roger Berman is number 2. Number 6 is Sean Finley from El Cajon, California. Finley currently is 3rd. Hot on the rear wheel of Roger Berman. Mendenhall still leads. Berman leads Sean Finley. They run side by side. Marty Hart has passed Jimmy White. Kawasaki, JP Racing, Gear Racewear are the major sponsors of one of the nicest guys you'll meet on this circuit. Little bit of a southern accent. He is a southern boy from North Carolina, Mendenhall, to the top of the jump. Sean Finley. Sean Finley is number 2. Who is number 3? Hart has moved up to 4. Marty Hart has come from dead last. He is number 3. My God, is he fast. Sean Finley and Mendenhall, you better crank. American Honda. We haven't changed our hat yet, but we could. For now, leads number. For now, leads Chris White and Rick Marshall and Brian Fuller. And where is Jimmy White? The last time we saw Marty Hart, he was 11th, passing 2 Ducatis. One of them was Jimmy White. He's now number 2. Number 3. Don't give it to him until he's caught it.
Oh, he is getting close.
He is flying. This track isn't set up to record lap times. If we were, I'll tell you, these guys are flat smoking. Mendenhall better get to it. The number 18 rider, Jimmy Eubanks from Raleigh, North Carolina. The Yamaha, a wounded player, who is the Honda rider, has dropped out. Number 159, Roger Berman on the sidelines. Oh no, the top privateer on the national circuit has gone to the sidelines, a wounded player. They're looking at the front end of the machine. Berman out of the Grand National main event. We go on, Mendenhall leads, Berman is out. Follow in the halfway through, and the Honda rider is third, it's yours.
Thank you, Rick. Some kind of racing this afternoon at the Thurston Off-Road Park here in the beautiful state of Washington. 250cc Pro main event. Your leader, Steve Mendenhall, factory support Kawasaki. And you saw Marty Hart had the lead, half a lap into the race. He rolled the three-run machine, and he was dead last. Dead last. He now is in third place. The greatest of all riders are here today, this afternoon. And again, the man from down in the East Coast, number 7, Steve Mendenhall. 1985 winning round number 3, the fourth place in round number 2, a couple weeks ago winning in Texas. He's third place on the points list so far. Second and third battle coming up at you now into the S's. Second place has got some company coming. Mendenhall, he's got a great lead, and again, we just passed the halfway point. Your leader started, your leader, number 7. Oh, what a terrible break for Steve Mendenhall. Mendenhall had some troubles, and you know what that means? Second and third is coming his way. The 17-year-old from California, Sean Finley, in second place. Number 1, national number 1 in third place, Marty Hart from Honda. Don't go away, folks. Keep your eyes on the front three. It's going to be a close one. Mendenhall, he knew he made a mistake. Check out this mid-pack action out there. Fennell slowing down at this point. Denny Fennell, also out there. 621, 466, the man from Shreveport, Louisiana. Don Neri sits on the outside. Some kind of racing this afternoon. There's Fennell, Denny Fennell, number 51. Number 82, the man from Mesquite, Texas, number 82, Jeffrey Barker from Mesquite, Texas. Here's your leader now, coming out into the S's. And again, the host of others, Rick Marshall, Brian Fuller, Ricky Rupert, Greg Wolf, Mendenhall, your leader, Fidel, Sean Finley in second, Mike Olmsted, Ron Fields, and look at second and third, Finley's got somebody knocking at the door. There's your leader now, Steve Mendenhall. But who's out there for second and third? It's still Finley on the Kawasaki, for factory support, rider from Kawasaki. Here comes Marty, gonna pass him right in front of you. On the inside, Marty Hart is now in second place. Let him know you're out there, folks. Let him know you're out there. If you're a Marty Hart lover. Finley draws back to third. He's still riding with Hart. But again, Marty Hart came from last place. On the board, they don't like the pry, but the boards are saying you can. 8 minutes, you can to Marty Hart. Now Mendenhall, number 7 again. He's out there in front by 100 yards. As the track has taken a toll, 159, Berman out of the program at this point. Ricky Rupert, number 51, running around the Tower House turn at this point, along with 527. Number 40, Chris Wright from Team Yamaha. But right now, we've got to keep our eyes on first and second. This will be the race of the year, folks. If Marty Hart can win this will be the race of the year. I guarantee you, right here in the Great Northwest, right in front of your hometown. You are some lucky people to see this happen. Make history. Number 7, Mendenhall, in hot pursuit. You know the man. He's wearing the number one plate. He's a national champion out of last year in the 250 Pro Rings. Here he comes down in front of you. There's Steve Mendenhall. And again, now he's got the lead, and he's working very well at this point. He stalled the motor and gave Finley and Hart a chance to catch up about 50 feet. Marty Hart is riding the race of his life. Can you believe this? He did not quit. He did not quit. He was last place, and he did not quit. He had 20 minutes to win. Sean Finley on the sidelines. I don't believe it. Sean Finley sitting on the sideline. Flat tire. The front tire is flat. What a bad break for the 17-year-old from California. Coming around the front straight out this number 129, Mr. Mike Olmsted, sponsored by Fresno Kawasaki. But right now, we've got riders all over the track. The most important two are in the back 40. Number seven, again, on the front, Hart in second. There's some more riders coming around the Tower House turn. Number 10, number 82, Barker. That's number 51, we believe, in between first and second. Now he's a lap down, and that's Denny Fennell. Dangerous Denny. It's hard to believe races take this type of shape and form. Fennell, very, very sportsmanlike, moves to the infield and lets Hart pass him as Fennell, again, a lap rider. But it is the best here in the nation today. In front of you here, 250cc Pro main event. And again, if we look for the other riders, Jimmy White, and a host of others. There goes Jimmy now, right in front of the powerhouse turn from the factory Kawasaki. Someone losing bits and pieces out there, like no seat. And there he is right now, coming in front of you there, the rider with no seat. Now that's got to be a feat. He will not last very long without a seat. But look at him, he's still racing. He is still trying to run. It's incredible, the sportsmanship. The competition level is at its peak. Here comes your leader now, factory support Kawasaki, Steve Mendenhall. From North Carolina, JP Racing Gear, Racewear, Team Green, Kawasaki, Mendenhall. Here comes Mendenhall, and right behind him, Team Honda. Marty Hart. Once again, riders throughout the field. First and second, and I really, I'll be honest with you, I can't really tell you who's in third place at this time, because this fine youngster right here. Fine youngster, hell, that's Jimmy White. Yeah, he could be in third place very easily, Jimmy White. From factory Kawasaki in third place. Denny Fennell, 45. Denny Fennell is a lap down, number 45. Out there at the top program, Brian Fuller from Santa California, sponsored by Danny's Machine Works, Duncan Racing and Trick at Maxim. 20 minutes have left. One more lap. Mendenhall wins this. I believe that he could regain the lead in the point structure. Marty Hart will stay very well up there in second place, but Marty does not want second place. Marty Hart wants to win. Mendenhall wants to win. Jimmy White wants to win. They all want to win. But the only two riders can do it at this point is either Steve Mendenhall or Marty Hart. Once again, that was Denny Fennell in between the first and second. Fennell wisely puts it to the outside and very graciously lets Marty Hart from Team Honda in around him. This has been some kind of race. Steve Mendenhall running the race of his life at this point. He knows one crucial error, and that's all there is. Imagine leading this thing for 19 and a half laps, or 20 and a half laps, whatever it's been, and then lose it on the final 50 feet or 60 feet. It'll be devastating. More flat tires, more bikes on the infield. But he's around the S's. Marty Hart not more than 30 feet behind him. He's going into the final turn. He's looking for one thing, the checker flag. Ladies and gentlemen, Kawasaki. Steve Mendenhall for your win. Second place, Marty Hart from Honda. 1 and 2 coming your way here in the 250cc Pro main event.
Sully, the greatest pro race you will see in the Pacific Northwest in 1986. Kawasaki, Steve Mendenhall. But the machines that didn't make it to the finish line, I mean the lime green motorcycles were dropping.